Подземные скальные мегалитические города.
Underground rock and megalithic towns, more precisely their ruins, because towns themselves are not present, only their former remains, are often connected by a system of ancient stone roads. Why stone? Because it is not those asphalt or dirt roads that we used to see. These are the roads which, as we now say it, were carved in stone. Both ruts that were imprinted in stone, like the tracks of dinosaurs or other extinct animals that once passed, and then their trace petrified. Stone roads and petrified ruts from car wheels are widely preserved throughout the Mediterranean region. Especially great number of stone roads and ruts is it in Spain. We saw two types of such formations. Firstly, these are roads that have a clear profile, two sides and ruts between the sides. They stretch over long distances. Many roads bifurcate, divide into three, climb the mountains with serpentine, making very interesting loops, and end in rock towns. The second type is individual petrified ruts from single passages of wheeled vehicles. There are many of such ruts in Turkey. There are entire regions, whole areas of stone ruts. For example, the largest area of ruts in Cappadocia's dimensions, 100 km per 160 km. You can imagine, inside there are separate sections of ruts with a length of several kilometers and even several tens of kilometers. The second area of development of stone ruts is located between the Turkish cities of Afyon and Eskişehir. It stretches from north to the south for about 70 km with a width of 10 km. Inside it, there are also separate sections of ruts, which in turn consist of clusters of ruts up to 800 meters in length. First, I want to talk about more interesting first formations – roads. Stone roads are widespread in the Iberian Peninsula in Spain. They are found in the provinces of Valencia, Castilla-La Mancha, Murcia, Andalusia, as well as in a number of other provinces, both in the north and in the west of Spain. One of the most interesting stone roads is situated in the autonomous region of Valencia. It is called Castello de Meca. We were lucky to be there in May 2016. Lucky in the literal sense of the word, because it is a private area. By agreement with the Minister of Culture of Spain, they are allowed to be tourists on Sundays. We had a whole day to explore this wonderful area. Stone road of Castello de Meca is a serpentine climbing the Table Mountain. There are remains of ancient rock structures, pits, ruins of various structures on it. I call such formations on rock plateaus bounded from all sides by abruptly slopes or Table Mountains by elevations. The stone road along its entire length has a distinct profile, and the ruts inside it are deeply buried in the ground. Now it is a limestone of the middle-late Minoan age. The road there in place bifurcates, divided into three, intersected by other roads. The main road first goes along the top of the mountain, then goes to the canyon up to 5 meters or more. It makes a few serpentines. In the lower part of the slope, after the next turn, the road has a very interesting structure. The ruts and limestones are broken by faults, individual pieces of the roadway, which ruts rush down the slope. Then the road is lost in the contrary sediments on which the grass grows. Everything indicates that this is really a Neogene road, which is lost in the contrary sediments at the bottom. Another interesting stone road in Spain is situated between the rock town of Tirmes and the undergrounds of Burga de Osma north of Madrid. We visited Tirmes during the expedition of 2016. This road passes not in limestones, but in middle-late Miocene red sandstones, gravelites and conglomerates which have an age from 15 to 10 million years. As in Castello de Meca, the stone road of the rock town of Tirmes first goes along the top of the plateau. Of the descent from the plateau, it forms a canyon. The remains of this canyon are preserved in several places. Here the profile of the road is clearly visible. Then the road goes down, forming a serpentine through not as obvious as in Castello de Meca. First it goes along the rock ledge of the town of Tirmes and leaves approximately 100 km north to the Burg de Osma area. This road was explored by Spanish archaeologists. It is very interesting that a modern dirt road covers the most part of it. Only some places where Neogene reddish deposits appear on the surface, stone ruts appear. In general, this is an extremely interesting place because above the road on the slopes we see the gutters and ledges carved into the rock. The road ends with underground facilities in Burga de Osma. That is, it connected earlier the rock town of Termes and the rock underground town of Burga de Osma. We see a similar road in the mountainous Crimea. This road is best seen in Chufut-Kale, the most famous rock town. The sides of the road are fairly flat and vertical, of a small height of about 30-40 cm. Between them are located ruts. Often these are two ruts, sometimes three ruts following a parallel course. Often the ruts intersect into each other. It can be seen that they are left not by one vehicle. Several wheel vehicles pass by here. First, the road passes along the upper part of the rock town, then the descends, keeping the profile of the road with ledges of 30-40 cm. Then it is lost now under the quaternary sediments. A very good stone road which forms a serpentine climbing up the mountain is situated near the rock town of Eskikermen. It is strongly smoothed by erosion and looks quite ancient. This road is easily distinguishable from the air. She bends several rock ledges before entering the gorge into the rock town of Eskikermen. We studied such stone roads in large numbers in October 2016 in central Italy. There are many of them in the territory of the Etruscan cities of Sarana, Savana and Pitigliano. They are unique roads. They are carved or excavated in the thickness of tufts, and the height of such man-made ravines reaches 10 and sometimes 15 and even 20 meters. On such roads, the ruts are not always visible, as in Spain and the Crimea. What is connected with, I do not know. Perhaps the ruts are covered with later quaternary sediments. In some places, the ruts are clearly visible. These roads connect rock towns. In Turkey, central Anatolia and Cappadocia, ruts from one-time rolling of wheeled vehicles are well developed. They are here in large numbers and form whole fields. The largest fields reach in Cappadocia a size of 100 to 166 km in the Phrygian valley between Efion and Eskihir, 70 per 10 km. Inside the fields, individual ruts run parallel to each other, cross each other. All of them are quite visible from the air. Stone ruts are probably the most interesting part of ancient rock complexes. They allow me to look at all the ruins of rock underground complexes, weak the mind from the geological side. All the ancient ruins of rock, underground and megalithic towns and stone roads are confined to the Neogene planation plain. What is Neogene planation plain or surface? It is also called peneplain. It is in essence a Neogene land, the land which existed approximately 15-11 million years ago, according to some sources up to 7 million years ago, in different places in different ways. There are a lot of such planation plains in the world. They can have a Jurassic, Cretaceous and Early Age. Footprints of dinosaurs, Paleogene and older animals are often situated on the planation plains. They have deposits of bauxite, silicate, nickel, ores, kaolin and some other minerals. That is in a fairly well-known formations. As I said, all stone roads and ruts are confined to the Neogene planation plains. Moreover, they are deformed as well as the planation surface itself, broken by faults, smoothed by erosion, covered with crust of secondary minerals. These crusts are clearly visible in many photographs. All this suggests that the ruts and rock underground complex have a Neogene age. Thank you. see many other structures on the Neogene planation plain that can be attributed to the rock complex. They differ from the typical ruins of towns and structures included in the rock complex. This is a variety of pits and wells. This is a series of graves and some ditches. Many of them have a human form. There are trenches and stone stairs, some T formations that cross each other. In addition, there are a lot of small round holes that were formed as a result of the operation of drilling machines. Most archaeologists consider that they were cutting rocks with the help of silicon, copper, of iron chisels and other primitive tools, depending on the age how they date. They also lack the rock complex, carrying no material remains. Their age cannot be determined with the help of archaeological methods alone. Yes, and with the help of geological methods it is quite difficult. Study these structures, working on them, seeing them in large numbers in different countries, and then returning in Russia and walking around the construction sites, seeing the same pits, wells, in real life, seeing a huge number of their photos on the internet, I realized that there was no difference between them. Only one was excavated in the ground, others were petrified. As a rule, they are located on the middle-late Miocene planation plain, the age of which is determined between 15 and 11, perhaps 7 million years ago, in different places in different ways. Common bearings that derives from traveling of wheel vehicles are also on the Neogene planation plain. They carry the traces of squeezing out dirt, scratching the side surfaces by excess of wheels and other signs that cars were traveling when the soil was wet and vicious. As on modern dirt roads after rain, the sort of roads that pits where graves and stairs were excavated at a time when the ground was not yet petrified. It turns out that all these formations are associated with the Neogene complex, which is widespread in the Mediterranean region. Its outcrops are available particularly in all countries of the world. They can also be attributed together with stone roads and ruts to the ancient rock underground megalithic complex, as to some single mega formations that ancient civilizations left. The study of various rock complexes allowed me to put forward a hypothesis that many rock structures and underground rooms were all not so cut, but excavated in the ground when it was not completely petrified. Of course, these were not structures in mud, but it was something like a dugout in which hunters and fishermen spent the night. I was unexpectedly received confirmation of this when I was passing the city of Guadix in the Spanish province of Andalusia. I saw there a large number of underground houses with pipes in which the local population lives. They were made in completely petrified soil in the hills consisting of non-petrified sediments. Now there are reports that some hot countries are moving to the construction of such underground houses, cut or rather dig out rooms under the ground which are constantly cool. These underground rooms represent autonomous dwellings. It turns out that even a part of rock and underground structures could be excavated when the Neogene planation plain, the Neogene land represented the soil, but not petrified rocks. Then, of course, in millions of years they were repeatedly rebuilt, already in a stone state, to adapt to the needs of the populations that lived later. I saw this many times in Cappadocia when I was in Adyrrhachi, Kaimakli, Oxoniak and other underground towns. There were see at least three stages of construction. We see how the underground towns expanded. Some of them adapted for people of normal build, others were made for some dwarfs whose growths didn't exceed 80 cm. There are a lot of such passages. We have to go bending. In Bucarente, Spain, this is a whole underground town in which, judging by the height of the ceilings of 80 cm, people of very small size lived. When you climb through the floors, half of your body is at the same height and half is on the other. Clearly, such towns are suitable for the needs of some dwarfs, hobbits or gnomes.